Je me trouve un peu blanche. Comme ça. Oula. Oh, c'est encore pire. Je suis la couleur du papier peint. Bonjour, bonjour, fragrance lover. Welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm giving you my first impression of Navitus fragrances. So I have a discovery set with me. So if you want to know more about these fragrances, stay with me. So before you watching this video, please remember to subscribe to my channel to support me. It means a lot to me because it's a lot of work every day. So please subscribe, leave me a little comment as well if you want to chat a little bit with me. And follow me on Instagram as well if you want to see a bit more every day. I don't know if you know Navitus Fragrances, but the creative director, I think we can call him like that, is actually Steven from the channel, the fragrance channel Redolescence. So he's really big and really impressive channel actually. Steven has been reviewing fragrances since years now. He's really good at niche and very high quality fragrances. He's also been a judge for the Fragrance Foundation, I think, and he was nominated for an award as well. So, you know, like, great. So I think just a little intro before. So I've been meeting Steven 2 weeks ago, 1 week ago, 2 weeks ago. Anyway, yeah, he's been coming to London. So we've been meeting with other reviewers as well. And it was great to meet up with everyone. So I was lucky enough to meet Steven. And I have to say, if I can say something about him, is that he's the most nicest and kind guy I've ever seen, really. No, seriously, like he's so nice. He's very, like, he's listening to you, you know, like it's just generally like I only had positive vibe that is coming to me when I'm thinking about Steven now. So he's also very interesting, and I can tell he's very passionate as well, driven by work. I love people driven by work. So yes, very hardworking. So he's coming up with this brand Navitus, and he's been working, I think, in cooperation with some perfumers. But yeah, so it's, I think, his babies. So today I'm gonna give you my first impression. So I've got a little discovery set. So I'm gonna give you a closer look to it. I've recorded a video with Steven for his channel that I don't know when it's going to be launched, but anyway, I've recorded a video with him and I tried a few of his fragrances, three of them, but because I've got the memory of a goldfish, I can't remember which one I've tried. So I'm going to retry it. Oh no, I don't know if they're inside, but yes, so let's try those one. I didn't do any little research as usual, just because I wanted to not be spoiled by the ingredient, and I want really to discover it by myself and tell you my honest review about it. So let's get it started. My first thing when I open the box is it's really smelling a lot, but I think, as I understood, it's like kind of like extrait de parfum concentration, so it must be like really high in concentration, because just from that, it smells a lot. I love very opulent fragrance. So from the impression I remember I had of trying this fragrance, I really like them. So yes, I'm expecting a lot. So the first one we're gonna try is Navitus. I really like the fact that the discovery set is like organized like this, and you have the name and the fragrance here, and it's magnetized as well. It's really lovely. So you can buy this set, I think, for something like, what did I see last time? Around $50, I think, something like that. So I don't know what he's doing in pound, but anyway. It's great, it's smelling really nice. And it's like not like small samples, they're quite big actually. So as you can tell. Okay, so enough talking, let me spray the first one. So that's Navitus. So it's obviously like Latin name, I think. Navitus, I think, means something like energy, passion, something like that. So I think he wants basically to say that when you're wearing a fragrance, you have this energy and it brings you, I don't know, confidence, character, you know, things like that. So it's quite interesting. Anyway, okay, so let's see Nevus. So, so I review also the sample bottle. Do you know what? Like when you have a lot of samples, some are just not spraying. It's so annoying. This is like a straightforward spray. Like it's a very thick one, dynamic, so it's nice. Like it. Okay, so let's see what it smells like. So Navus. I will put the notes, ingredients in there on the editing for you. Oh. This smells very energetic. That's my first feeling. Because I can smell a lot of citrus. Yeah, lots of citrus. I can smell something a bit greener as well. Citrusy, sharp, but very green. Quite earthy as well. I don't know if there's vetiver inside, but it's the kind of vetiver, if there is like that, I like, because it's quite uplifting, vetiver. It's very energetic. That's definitely something I would wear more for the spring summer. Very dynamic. Now I can see like there's a quite like woody undertone. It's really nice because it makes me think of Acqua di Parma fragrance, because they citrus are nice because they have a very long stay and longevity. You can tell because there's a woody trail. This really smells like this. I need to write down everything, otherwise I'll be lost. Where is my pen? Navus. Okay, so that's Navus. And thank you, Dior, for sponsoring my little brothers. It's a joke. I just took them. Yeah, I really like that. That's the most active one. But we're going to see that at the end. Okay, let's not spend that much time, otherwise the video is going to be 30 minutes and you're going to scream. But let's see the second one. So it's called Intimus. I don't know if you say it in English. Intimus? I like Intimus. French way. Okay, those, just by the name, probably is going to be a bit more discreet. Like maybe a bit more enveloping or something like that. Love this spray. Love it. Oh. Oh là là, I think I really like it. Oh. Wow, that's amazing. Oh là là, I can smell a lot of oriental note, I think, inside. It's definitely an oriental. There's for sure something like tonka bean, vanilla or benzoin, something like that. This is the usually the oriental. But it smells flowery as well, very solar, very uplifting. It gives me like luminosity into darkness, because it smells quite like a, oh, that's so nice. Like it smells powdery. Do you know, it makes me think of, in much more refined though, much more refined, something like Viva la Juicy, Gold Couture, but this is much better, I have to say. It smells much more contrasted, much more refined. But I can also smell something quite uplifting at the beginning. So there must be some citrus again. Oh, it's beautiful. That is much more feminine to me. It smells a bit like sweeter, rounder, cocooning, like this kind of fragrance you want to cuddle. Nearly like a bonbon, a bit caramel-like. More sugary. But I can smell a lot of flowers too. Oh, this is amazing. Oh, I love it. It smells quite powdery as well. Oh, I love that. Okay, I love it. Okay, love it. Okay, next one. Next one is called Prima. Primas, something like that. I don't know. Maybe like something quite basic, simple. That's what it makes me think of, the name. Okay, let's see Prima. Oh, greener, spicier. Oh, it's much more earthy. Do you know what? It smells, the first impression it smells, it smells like the ground after it's raining. Also like something quite herbal inside. Nulli medicinal. Oh, it's nice too. Oh, it really smells like something from the ground after the rain. It's more mossy, definitely more mossy. It's more like a foresty kind of scent. But I can smell a lot of deepness. Don't know why, I smell a bit more mintiness. Same, it's quite powdery, musky. I like that. I don't know if I would wear it though. It's quite like, same. I think I would wear it, I would really enjoy it wearing to spring. It smells nearly minty to me. But definitely much more earthy. I don't know if there's like a earthy patchouli or something like that. It smells more vintage to me, very green. Casual chic outfit. A gentleman will wear that with a beige outfit. I'm going too far. That's really the scent of a gentleman to me, actually. Very delicate, but still very mossy after some time. Okay, so that's Prima. Actually, I think the name matches really good because Prima makes me think of something primary, basic, in a good way. And this for me is like the typical kind of gentleman scent. It's really nice. It's very different from the earthy that I smelled before, so really interesting. All of them for now are very strong though, even though they're quite uplifting. They're very, I can smell, intense. That's nice because you want your fragrance to hold and to have some longevity, but the most important to give you confidence, power, you know. So we have Absolutio. It's difficult when the name are not in French. I'm usually like having good times with French perfumery, but yeah. Okay, so that is Absolutio. Wow. Oh, this is nice. Oh, I love it. It smells very almondy. Oh, that's nice. It smells like a cake. Like a nice chocolate cake. It smells chocolatey, or chocolatey but slightly almondy. Oh, guys, it smells like a galette des rois in France. If you don't know what it is, you can't understand this, but nearly like almondy. Yeah, very almondy. I can smell some spices as well. Oh, that's so nice. This is a bit more wintery, but will be nice to wear in summer as well because still quite uplifting. I can smell some green undertone. There's a fruit probably in there as well because it's nearly smelled like a little cocktail mixed with some chocolate cake, almondy. Wow, that's really nice. I really like that, and usually I'm difficult with almondy scent because for me they're too characteristic, like too unique. I don't know how to explain it. I love that though. I really like that. That's definitely my type of fragrance, to be honest. Like I knew it, even when I've seen before Steven showed me the three fragrances he showed me in his video. I knew I was gonna like it just because of the packaging. It's weird, but it looks very high luxurious, and when I look at this, I see something pretty strong fragrances. I was expecting this, so I'm pretty happy. Then we have Oud Imperium. I love a oud. Bunny loves a oud. Okay, let's see this one. Oud Imperium. Oh, I'm gonna do that all the time. So, discreet type of oud. I could really smell it at the beginning, Nice going. It smells a bit more warmer, oriental as well, very oriental. It's very relaxing though. It's not a wood that is sharp, or not a wood like, I've got wood for greatness in here from Initial. It's not like this, it's not like a strong, powerful, crazy wood, you know. This is much more like a refined one, delicate. Oh, I really like that. This is very elegant. That's a very elegant hood. I don't know, I can smell some, maybe lavender? Because it's very relaxing. And it's got that mintiness to it. I never smelled a hood that smelled that bright, that luminous. Oh, that's really nice. It's really something that I didn't smell before. It's very creamy type of hood, delicate without being sweet. Really nice. It's like a morning type of hood. I don't know if that explaining it. So that's Oud Imperium. I really like that. And then the last one is Oud Luxuria. So that's something I would like. Another hood, so let's see how does it compare with the other hood. Hola! Okay, I see why Oud Luxuria. It's because it's much more sharper. This one only smells like animalic. Incensey. Like nearly religious type of hood. Do you remember, like, I don't know if you've seen my last video about sexy fragrances. I'll link it here. I said about fucking fabulous that is nearly smells like something forbidden in religious, so forbidden. This smell a bit like that, very religious, but extremely strong. This one, strong, sharp, incensey, smells quite leathery too, like a leather jacket, but a very classy one. Oh, this smells money, guys. This is the sexy one. And it smells nearly like, I can smell a lot of spices at the now. Lots of spice, nearly like pepper-like. I don't know if there's pepper, but it does smell a bit peppery. Really nice, Oud Luxuria. Yeah. So let's smell all of them and let me give me final words about them. So let's try the first one that was Navus. Navus is the uplifting one, is a sporty one. Energetic. Well, I won't say sporty because it would actually not give it its full justice, because it's much more than just a uplifting fragrance. I can smell very a green undertone. Beautiful. Spring and summer. Definitely gonna like that. And it's got something nearly clean, soapy as well. Really interesting. Then we have Intimus. I'm dying from this one. So nice. It smells much more flowery, I think much more feminine. But I would see it on a man too, to be honest, because yeah, you want to eat this one. It smells a bit sugary as well. Oh, I see what it's called, Intimus. Like I would, it's a bit very sexy scent for a lady. A lady wearing that, so nice. Even on a man, I think it would be like quite sexy. But it's a bit more flowery as I can smell. I love this one, I love this one, I'm in love. Then we had Prima. Prima is the earthy one, the most vintage, gentleman kind of scent. Very grassy, mossy, spicy, in a really nice way. It's not too sharp in the greenness. Nice. Then we have Absoluto. Where is it? Where are you? Ah, this is so good. A gourmand type of scent. Definitely, that's the gourmand one of the collection. Oriental, almondy. Ah, that's delicious. I want to eat it. Delicious. Then we have Virtus. Where are you, Virtus? Did I try Virtus? Oh, I'm missing one. Wait. Stop everything. It's not a blotter, it's the price tag of my jacket. That will do, I don't have any more, okay? I need to buy some more. So Virtus, I didn't try Virtus, that's weird. Let me see how much was it. No, I didn't try that. So that's this smells much more fruitier, a bit more spicier. Oh, that's nice. I like that. It smells like very round. Very round and creamy. Creamy, white, creamy. Again, I think there's some vanilla. It smells a bit honeyed. A little bit honeyed, creamy. Again, it smells a bit nutmeggy. Maybe Steven likes nutmeg. It's very uplifting too, but it smells much more like cocooning, creamy, white. A bit like a dessert as well, but a white dessert, like a very uplifting, creamy one. Really like that too, really nice. Oud Imperium, that's the most delicate oud, very soothing, bright, morning oud, daytime oud, really nice, like a delicate one. If it's your first step to your oud, you might like this because it smells very delicate and soothing. And Oud Shaya, oh, I'm dying. This is amazing. I can smell some rose now. Oh, this is the sexiness in a bottle. Sexy oud, sharp. That's great. That's really great. It smells nearly animalic. That's nice. That's really nice.
My favorite.
I chose my favorite. It's really difficult. To be fair, I really like them all. I think they have a lot of contrast. They all have, I feel, like a quite woody undertone, warmer. They all smell a bit mysterious as well. Very that mystic kind of vibe because they smell like it's. I know that this kind of scent would react differently on my skin and would evolve as well, not be flat, will change with the time, which I really, really enjoy. I love when my fragrance is moving and I can discover more and more about it every day. So I feel they're very complex fragrance as I can smell. And I can smell a lot of quality in there. Like, trust me, I can smell a lot of quality. And I can smell, for me, it's definitely have a sharpness, strongness of like an extrait de parfum. It smells ultra luxurious. I really enjoy it. My favorite will be, I don't know, I absolutely love the Absolutio. Absolutio, that's how it calls. Yeah, this one is magical. I would smell that all day. That is so nice because it's a good balance between something quite strong and opulent and something also very refined. So I feel that would be for me. That is amazing. I also have a little crush on Virtus. It smells very creamy, nearly like milky, like a dessert. I love that. I really love that. Very cute. And I love Intimus because it smells a bit more ladylike as well. Flowery, still bright. I want to eat it, really slightly sugary. It's beautiful. I have to say, between the two ouds, I really love the Oud Imperium, I have to say, because usually I'm more for the strongest one, but this one, I smell it very soothing, relaxing, gentleman-like, lady-like. Very unisex though, oh my god. Yeah, I love the other one too, but if I have to choose for myself, the Imperium. So good. I think if I have to choose between everything, I will take Absolutio and Oud Imperium. That's for me the best. I love them. I really like the other one. I really like the fact that it doesn't smell like something I smelled before. So I really, I really recommend you to have a try. I think the video was really long, but it's great. It's really great. So, love it. Love it. So that's it for my discovery. I hope you like it. I hope that will give you the curiosity to have a look about Navitus fragrance, because it's really great. I'm really impressed about this fragrance. Like, that smells quality as hell. It's really amazing. So what would I say to you is probably like nothing, actually. What did I want to say? Ridiculous. Anyway, like, I remind you, please subscribe to my channel if you watch the all way through, and I will see you shortly on Sunday, and I wish you a good end of the week, middle of the week. That's it. See you soon. Bye bye.